Hello friends,
today we will discuss about charge distribution, right? In this topic we will discuss about linear charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density, right? Now here in charge distribution we will distribute charge uniformly on the line, on surface and on volume, right? So first of all we distribute charge on line, so we will discuss about linear charge density. Now what is linear charge density, right? So linear charge density is defined as the total amount of charge to the length, right? I can repeat, linear charge density is total amount of charge per unit length. So linear charge density is known as total amount of charge per unit length is called linear charge density. Now surface charge density is total amount of charge per unit area is called surface charge density. These are the definition, friends. You have to remember this. What is linear charge density? So total amount of charge per unit length is called linear charge density. Total amount of charge per unit area is called surface charge density. And total amount of charge per unit volume is called volume charge density, right? So these are the definitions of linear surface and volume charge density, right? So total amount of charge per unit length is called linear charge density, total amount of charge per unit area is called surface charge density, and total amount of charge per unit volume is called volume charge density. So here the linear charge density is given by lambda. So see here, the symbol of linear charge density is lambda. So lambda is equals to total amount of charge, so total charge is q, per unit length, so lambda is equals to q by l. Then surface charge density is given by sigma, so total amount of charge q per unit area, so q by a, right, where a is area. Then volume charge density is given by rho, so rho is equals to total amount of charge q per unit volume. So you have to remember the formula, or we can say we write the formula from the definition. Lambda is equals to q by l, surface charge density sigma is equals to q by a, and volume charge density rho is equals to q by v. Then unit and dimensional formula. So the unit is charge, the unit of charge is coulomb, and the unit of length is meter, so coulomb meter inverse. Here the unit is coulomb meter raised to minus 2, because the unit of area is meter square, so coulomb meter raised to minus 2. And the unit of volume charge density is coulomb meter raised to minus 3, right? Because the unit of charge is coulomb and the unit of volume is meter cube, so coulomb per meter cube, or we can say coulomb meter raised to minus 3. Then dimensional formula. So the dimensional formula of charge is A1T1, right? Upon dimensional formula of length L1, but L1 is in denominator, so we can write that L minus 1. So dimensional formula of linear charge density is L minus 1 A1 T1. For surface charge density, Coulomb A1 T1 area, the dimensional formula of area is L2, but L2 is in denominator, so L minus 2. Then dimensional formula of volume charge density for Coulomb A1 T1 and volume, the dimensional formula of volume is L3, but L3 is in denominator, so L minus 3. Right, so these are the unit and dimensional formula of linear charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density. Right. So now suppose we have to find out the electric field like this. See, this is the wire having a length L, right? So here at point something point P, we have to find out the electric field at point P. Now here on this line we distribute a charge uniformly. So here we distribute a positive charge uniformly, then here at point P we have to find out electric field. But first of all, this is the total length L. So here we have to take a component of L. So here the component of L is dl, right? So here suppose the position vector of this component is r. So here we have to find out the electric field at point P. So here we define a position vector from dl to P. So this position vector is r dash, and the position vector from O is capital R, like this. So here we have to find out the electric field at point P, but due to the total length L. So to find out electric field at point P, first of all we have to find out electric field due to the component dl, right? Now we know the formula of electric field. We know that E is equal to like this, Eq upon R square, right? We know the formula of electric field. But here we have to consider this is a length L. So here linear charge density comes into picture. So lambda is equal to Q by L. So here Q is given by lambda into L, right? So here we have to find out electric field due to the component dl, right? So here electric field due to length dl. So here we take a element of length dl. So first of all we have to find out electric field due to length dl, right? Or you can say delta L as you wish, right? Now suppose here we consider a length of component delta L, right? So what happens? So here if we consider this length component, or we can say element of small element of length delta L, then the electric field is given by delta E is equals to K instead of Q. See here friends, Q is equals to lambda into L, right? So instead of Q we have to write lambda into L, but we have to find out electric field due to the small element delta L, right? So here we have to write instead of L delta L upon, here see the distance from delta L to point P, R dash, so upon R square, but instead of R square we have to write R dash square into R dash cap. Now, this is the electric field due to the small element having a length delta f. We have to find out the total electric field. So, we already discussed that if we want to find out the total electric field, so we have to take integration, right? So, the total electric field is equals to integration k lambda instead of delta l. We have to write dl upon r dash square r dash cap. So, this is the line integration, right? Because here we distribute charge on line having length l. So, to find out the total electric field, you have to use formula vector E is equals to integration k lambda dA upon r dash square into r dash cap. Right, again see your friends. Here this is a line having length L. So, here electric field at point P due to the small element of length delta L is given by E is equals to kp upon r square. So, here electric field due to the small element having a length delta L, delta E is equals to K instead of Q, Q is equals to lambda L. So, here we take a small element of length delta L. So, instead of L, we have to write delta L. So, K lambda delta L upon R dash square R dash cap. Now, to find out the total electric field, we have to take integration of it. So, total electric field E is equals to integration, here there is line, so this is line integral, K lambda instead of dA delta L, we have to write dA upon r dash square into r dash cap, right. Now, for surface charge density, now for that consider this is the surface like this. Now, consider this surface and the small element of area is delta A, right? So, the position vector is here, this is R, here at point P, we have to find out electric field. So, this position vector is R dash. So, the position vector from this point O to P is vector R. Right. So, same thing here we do for line, now for area. Now, electric field due to the element or we can say small element delta A. So, the electric field due to the small element delta A is given by delta E is equals to, again see the formula, E is equals to kq upon r square. So here there is area, so we have to consider the surface charge density. So the charge is given by q is equals to sigma into E, right. So q is equals to sigma into A, so here we have to consider the small element delta A instead of capital A. So, Q is equals to sigma into A. So, here vector E is equals to kq upon r square, but Q sigma into delta A. So, sigma into delta A upon, see the position vector is r dash, so r dash square into r dash cap. Now, this is the electric field due to the small element delta. We have to find out the total electric field. So, again we have to take integration. So, E is equals to integration. But here there is a surface. So, this is the surface integration. So, K sigma instead of delta, we have to write dA r dash square r dash cap. Right. So, this is the electric field due to this small element delta E k instead of q sigma into A, but instead of A we have to write component of area delta E. So k sigma delta E upon r dash square into r dash cap. To find out the total electric field we take surface integration of delta E. So k sigma instead of delta a, that is dA upon r dash square into r dash cap. Now same thing we do for volume. So see here, consider this. Now here the position vector of this volume element, suppose the volume element is delta V, right? So the volume element is delta V. So the position vector from O to this is vector R. Here we have to find out field at point P. So here the position vector from delta V to P is R dash, and then position vector from O to P like this. O to P is vector R, right? Now we have to find out electric field at point P, but due to this small element delta V, so electric field due to small element delta V. So here delta E is equals to, again we know the formula, Aq upon R square, but here there is volume, so the charge Q is given by rho into V, right? So E is equals to Kq upon R square. So K as it is, Q is equals to rho into V. So here rho into small component is, or we can say small element is delta V, upon position vector instead of R square, R dash square, R dash square, right? Again we have to find out the total electric field. So to find out the total electric field, we have to take integration of delta E. So total electric field E is equals to, this integration is known as the volume integration. So volume integration K rho instead of delta V dV upon R dash square, R dash cap, right? So these are the formulas of electric field due to the small element of length delta L, due to the area element delta A, and volume element delta V, right? Now this question are asked in 2 marks. The question is like this: explain linear charge density, explain surface charge density, and explain volume charge density, right? And friends, you have to remember the definition of linear surface and volume charge density, right? If you remember the definition, then you can easily derive the formula, dimensional formula and unit of this, right? Okay, so these are the uniform charge distribution, right? So the question is also like this: explain the uniform charge distribution. So if question is like asked like this, explain uniform charge distribution. So in uniform charge distribution, you have to explain the linear surface and volume charge density. Okay,